This is like my first tapping ASMR video. So I know it's not like mini. Just your noise, that's my dog. I know this really isn't like mini weenie related, but I kind of figured that I would do like an ASMR video. Let me switch my so that way you guys can hear the tapping a little bit easier. So yeah, I'm gonna be tapping on like on a book and like a CD and some other little props here. So yeah, I might also be like whispering a little too. Does that get people? Like, I've never done these things before, but we'll see. The first thing I'm tapping on is pretty at the beach lotion. The keynotes are blushing beach, jasmine petals, wine nectarine, tend to stutter a lot, so don't judge me for that, please. Though I'd have had a reason enough in the last few months, but even if I had, I would not have wondered, I would not have imagined it like this. Sorry. I stared without breathing across the long room into the dark eyes. Into the dark eyes of the hunter, and he looked pleasantly back at me. Surely it was a good way to die, in the place of someone I loved, noble even, that ought to count for something. I knew that if I had never gone to Forks, I wouldn't be facing death now. But I was terrified, but terrified as I was, I couldn't bring myself to regret the decision. When life offers you a dream so far beyond your expectations, it's not reasonable to grieve when it comes to an end. The hunter smiled in a friendly way, as he slumped hard forward to count me. Did you guys watch the Twilight Saga? And if you did, did you like it? And what was your favorite movie so far? What is your favorite movie so far? About three things I was absolutely positive. First, Edward was a vampire. Second, there was a part of him, and I didn't know how dominant that part might be, that thirsted for my blood. And third, I was unconditionally and irrevocably in love with him. The Twilight Saga. Eclipse.
New Moon.
Eclipse.
And Breaking Dawn.
Did you watch Breaking Dawn? Did you watch part one, or did you guys watch part two? Let me know in the comments down below. This other one is my favorite. I'd had more than my fair share of near-death experiences. It wasn't something you really ever get used to. It seemed oddly inevitable, though. Facing death again, like I was really marked for disaster. I'd escaped time and time again, but it kept coming back for me. This time was so different from others. You could run from someone you feared. You could try to fight someone you hated. All my reactions geared towards those kinds of killers. The monsters. The enemies. When you really loved someone, when you really loved the one who was killing you, it left you no options. How could you run? How could you fight? When doing so would hurt the beloved one, that beloved one. If your life was all you had to give to your beloved, how could you not give it? If it was someone you truly loved. Breaking Dawn to me was very explanatory. It broke a lot of silence out of eclipse and new moon. New moon, Edward was hardly in it, but I thought it was very well done, especially for the CGI kind of stuff as well. I have all four of them. Breaking Dawn is somewhere in there. If I can find it, I'll probably pull it out. Yeah, it's in there. I don't pull it out because it's like underneath. Cause it's like stuck or something. This is New Moon. Here's Edward.
Edward. Edward.
Bella. Bella. And Jacob. I have Twilight, the first movie. Edward here and Bella. This is the single disc. I know there's a two disc somewhere that I need to find. But it's the same movie, so why do I need two of them? Here is the second book, New Moon. Felt like I was trapped in one of those nightmares where I felt like I was trapped in one of those nightmares. The one where you have to run till your lungs burst. But you can't make your body move fast enough. My legs seemed to move slower and slower as I fought my way through the cowardly crowd. But the hands on the huge clock tower didn't slow. With relentless, uncaring force, they turned and struggled toward the end of everything. But this was no dream. Unlike the nightmare, I wasn't running for my life. I was racing to save something infinitely more precious. My own life meant little to me today. Alice had said that we could both die here. Perhaps the outcome could be different. If she weren't trapped by the brilliant sunlight. Only I was free to run across this bright crowded square, and I couldn't run fast enough. So it didn't matter to me that we were surrounded by extraordinarily dangerous enemies. As the clock began to toll out the hour, vibrating under the soles of my sluggish feet, I knew it was too late. And I was glad something bloodthirsty waited in the wings. For in failing at this, I forfeited any desire to live. The clock tolled again, and the sun beat down from the exact center point of the sky. The next I have is like this one was a little slow, but it was still a really good movie. All our attempts at subterfuge had been in vain. With ice in my heart, I watched him prepare to defend me. His intense concentration betrayed no hint of doubt, nor no help at this moment. His family was fighting for their lives. His family was fighting for their lives just as surely as he was for ours. Would I ever learn to outcome that other fight? Find out who the winners and losers were? Would I live long enough for that? The odds didn't look so great. Black eyes, wild with their fierce craving for my death. Watched for a moment with my protector's attention would be deprived, would be diverted. Would be diverted. The moment when I would surely die, somewhere far, far away in the cold forest, a wolf howled. That was my first ASMR. I hope I did really good, guys. Let me know in the comments down below. And I will see you guys with a mini whinny video. Bye, guys.